Well, joining us now to answer your tax questions, Kara King Bess of King King and Associates. Hello.
Good morning.
Are you tired?
A little bit.
A lot of
two more days.
Two more days. All right. And a little extra time just means extra work for you. All right, let's get to the last few questions out there as we go into the tax day. Is it true that those that are on unemployment have to mail in their income tax and have 6 months to pay their taxes?
I believe that what the question is really focusing on is that about a month ago, the IRS expanded their Fresh Start program. And what it does is gives an additional 6 months for relief of failure to pay penalties for those who are unemployed, as well as those small business owners. So there's a new form, Form 1127, that may not be part of the current packages that are online right now. So you can actually go online to irs.gov/form1127 and download that form. And then you would have to attach that to your tax return and mail that in order to get that 6 month relief of failure to pay penalties. Mm-hmm. So what that also includes says that as long as you pay by October 15th, the IRS will give you relief of those failure to pay penalties. Mm-hmm. Because, of course, if you don't pay your taxes that are due April 17th, there are penalties and interest that start to accrue.
Okay.
So that form for unemployed individuals and for small business owners who saw a 25% or more decrease in their income because of the economy, they are eligible for that relief as well.
All right.
So that form will probably have to be mailed in along with your tax return. But what is important is that you mail in your tax return by the 17th, mm-hmm. along with that request for extension. If that isn't mailed by the 17th, you cannot get that relief.
Okay. I heard that if you owe taxes, you should not use a credit card. What other options are available if I am unable to get a loan and if I have no cash available?
First thing I would say is to, again, file that tax return by the 17th. And I think that what they're referring to is that the interest on credit card debt is probably a lot higher than the interest that the IRS charges. So file the tax return. Send what you can. Mm-hmm. Also ask for that 1127 that gives you 6 month relief of the penalties, and maybe 6 months from now you will be able to pay that. You know, if all else fails, use the credit card. But I think that the issue is that the credit card interest rate is a whole lot higher than the IRS's interest rates. So it would behoove you to try and use some other sources.
Okay.
Send something in each month until October 15th.
Okay. Just get it postmarked by midnight.
Right.
And sign it.
Sign it. If you can't pay, again, you have a couple of options. You can file the 4868, which is an extension of time to file the return. You have to pay something with that 4868. Also, for Maryland, there's the 502E extension of time to file. Send something with those returns. These are extensions of time to file your returns, mm-hmm. not of time to pay the balance. So if you've completed your return, go on and send it in, even if you can't pay.
Okay.
Ask for the installment agreement. There's another form called a 9465, which is an automatic installment agreement.
Mm-hmm.
And also as part of the IRS's Fresh Start, they expanded that from $25,000 up to $50,000. So if you have a liability anywhere from $0 to $50,000, you can get an automatic installment agreement.
Okay.
And it's form 9465. That can be attached to your return as well.
All right. Thank you so much.